So we can start the assembly of the plumber block. So in the left side, you can see the part library. Open this one. So open your file where you saved this, all the parts. You have to open that one. First, you have to drag the body. Okay. After this, you have to drag the bottom half. Okay. You can look at this one. Bottom face you have to select, and you have to center the. So it will be coincides like this. After this, you have to rotate like this. Select this one. Go for assembly. Select the extrude part and rotate like this. Okay. So you can select the close this one and select this one. So exactly it will be fixed. Okay. After this, you have to go for the top bearing. Okay. So here we have to select this single circle, and you have to select this one. So properly it will be matched. Okay. So after this, here you have to place the cap. So drag it. Okay. First you have to select the this hole to this hole. Okay. So drag it upwards. You have to select the face carefully. Select the face. This face to this face. So it will be neatly rotate. Okay. After this, you have to rotate this one. Okay. So go for assembly. Select the bottom face. Zoom it. Select the bottom face. Again, zoom it. Sorry, rotate carefully. You will get the bottom face to the top face. Okay. So it will be fixed properly. After this, you can see. Right click. Click the body. So for cap, it is given 0. You have to give 3. Enter. Okay, you can look at the gap now. 3 mm gap. Fit page. Okay. Control I. Okay. So here you have to place the bolt M10. Drag it like this. Select this one. Insert the hole. So it is fixed. Okay. You can drag it downwards this one. Okay. So I can rotate this one. It is not properly faced because this is 45 degree is given. Okay. So go for assembly. Select this face. Go for assembly. Select this any face and properly fix with respect to this face. So it will be rotated. Okay. Right. So after this, you have to again, you can look at this one. So here inside you have to place this bolt. Okay. So select the top face of the bolt. Okay. So select the top face of the bolt and rotate it. Okay. Close the rotation and select the inside face here. So it will be properly fixed. Okay. So control I again. So you have to fix the next will be nut M10. Place it like this. Okay. After this, select the inside threaded hole to the threaded part of the bolt. Okay, it's placed. Drag it upwards. Okay. So select the here this face to the front face. It will be properly fixed parallel to both the faces. Then you can rotate it. Okay, so close this one. Go for assembly. Select the bottom face. Select the bottom face and select the top face. So it will be properly fixed. Right? Again, control I. So choose the lock nut. drag it. Okay. In the parts, when I'm doing the parts, I'm changing the dimension here. I'm not done the angle cut. You have to do that one, especially for this one. Okay. So after this one, again same method. You have to select the inside threaded hole to the threaded part here. So properly it is face. Okay. After this, you have to select the face to the here. Okay. Adjust it parallelly. This one. After this, drag it upwards. This one. Okay. After this, rotate it. Okay. Close rotation. Select the bottom face. Assembly. Select the bottom face. And select the rotate this one. Close rotation. Select the top face. Okay. So control I. Everything is completed. So same thing you have to place in this hole also. Go for pattern. So open the reference planes. Go for pattern. First select the plane, then select the bolt, nut, and drag this one. Okay, all three parts you have to select and tick mark. Okay. See, look at this one. Finish. So both sides, bolt, nut, and lock nut will be placed. Okay. So control F. This completes the plumber block. So control T. Control B. So control I. Okay. And one more you have to place. That is a shaft. Okay. So drag the shaft. Okay. You have to select this one and select the inside the bearing, right? And you can look at this one. Select this face and select the reset reference box and select this face. So it will fix here. So go to the right click and go for the bearing bottom half or top half. I'll go for the bottom half. Click it this one and you can look at the shaft. Go for top half. See, shaft dimension is given here. You can give the minus 10. Okay, so you can go for the control R. So both sides equally is placed. If you give 60 mm, minus 5 if you give this one, so both sides will be placed properly. Okay, so control I. So shaft you can give 60. So I am here, I am given the 70. You can give the 60. Okay. So next you have to save this one. Save anywhere you want. You can save it. The plumber block can save it here. Save it this one. Okay. So and you can convert it into 2D. Next. Front. Next. Top, you can, if you want, you can go for the ISO drawing, finish and place it. Okay, you can look at the front view, top view, and isometric view. Cut the front view. Okay, go for sheet setup. Save default. Okay. So you can drag this one. Fit page. So drag the diagram inside. Okay. So select the diagram, change to scale. I'm giving 1:1 to 0.5 or 0.7. Okay. Now the diagram is small. As it is same, you have to go for this one, 0.8 or 0.7 also. Okay. After this, you have to go for the half section, go for cutting plane, select the diagram. You can look at this one. Okay. You have to, for this one, to show here, if you keep this one, it will show. Okay. So this one, it's not center for this one. This is, you have to select. Fix this one upwards as it is same. choose the endpoint. Downwards here. Okay. Close this one. Go for section part. Select this one. Upwards. Section of the plumber block will be appears. Okay. So here you have to go for part library. Select the part list. Click the diagram anywhere. So you can fix it here. So look at this one. In the go for properties, columns, document number is not required, delete column, apply, okay. Okay. So look at this one. As per the number, body, bearing top half, bearing, here you can change this one, bottom half, properties, data. So both are top half is given. Okay. So you can look at this one, number 3 is top half and 4 is the 2 and 3 will be the bottom half and the top half. Okay. So carefully check the number here. It will show us the 2 is the bottom half. Okay. Here, right click, allow for center override. Okay. So edit this one. If it is mistake, you can edit this one, bottom half. Right, apply, okay. Okay, so 2 is the bottom half, bearing top half, cap, bolt M10, nut M10. Here also, you can change it to lock nut M10. Okay, according to material, it will be appears. Okay, so now we can select the, press control and select all these things. So, go for the item count, right? This completes the diagram. Okay.